The prescription of antipsychotic drugs has jumped nearly 50% in less than a decade, according to a new study. To unpack it for us this morning, the study's co-author, Professor Roger Mulder from Otago University, joins us from Ōtautahi Christchurch. Morena, thanks for being with us.
Thanks.
How reliable is this data?
Well, New Zealand has actually very good data. We have about 98% of prescriptions are picked up by the Ministry of Health. And Sam Wilkinson, my co-author, worked with some of the ministry staff to collect this, so we can be very confident that this is a real thing, that it's not just a sample problem. This is pretty much a census of New Zealand prescribing.
Why has there been such a significant increase?
Yeah, well, that's unfortunately what our paper doesn't answer, but you could speculate. This increase has been found throughout the world, so it's not unique to New Zealand. It seems to be associated with using antipsychotics for other indications than psychosis. So these drugs were developed to treat schizophrenia and bipolar disorder, but they are now being used for things like anxiety, for sleep problems, and for other reasons. And we suspect that's the reason that we see this increase. We don't think it's because a lot more people in New Zealand are psychotic.
Right. So to be clear, are people using it for those other things like wanting to sleep or anxiety? Are they using that on doctor's recommendations, or are they just choosing to use it themselves?
The only way you could get it is through a script. So, I mean, one of the clues to this is that European women over 65 are the biggest users, and we don't think that's because they're all psychotic. We suspect, and in fact, there's some evidence that it's using very low doses to help people sleep. Particularly the drug quetiapine is used at low doses for anxiety and sleep. And this is called off-label prescribing. And I guess the concern is that we don't really have good evidence of the efficacy and safety for those indications because the studies have never been done.
So is it inappropriate that New Zealand doctors are prescribing these drugs?
Well, that's hard to say. I mean, there's very mixed feelings about that. So some people say, well, they work, we have limited options, let's do it. Others say, no, we shouldn't be prescribing until we have evidence. Ideally, what we'd like, of course, is a trial, a big trial that would look at comparing one of these drugs, say quetiapine, with a placebo to see do they actually work in helping people sleep.
So is it likely there have been any more, or that there are any more people suffering from psychotic disorders?
No, we don't really have evidence for that. So there's been a big review of off-label prescribing in OECD countries, and it suggests that it's not that really it's because they're being prescribed for sleep, for PTSD, for generalised anxiety and those sort of things.
It sounds like quite a broad range of things they're being prescribed for.
Yes, that's true. And that, again, is something that I guess is of some concern. It would be, you'd feel a lot more confident if studies were done in these groups of people and said, yes, they work well. And the other problem is we don't know for how long you should prescribe them. Should you give them to people for 2 or 3 weeks? Should you give them for longer? And so I think once... The good thing about the study is it alerts us to this, and the data is such we can actually now go back and look at who's getting them, what are the doses they're getting them in, and we may even be able to try and link it to their diagnoses.
How long would it be before we had any definitive evidence from a longer-term study as to the effectiveness for those other disorders?
I don't know. I mean, it seems to me really surprising that those studies have never been done. There's some very small studies looking at the use in sleep, and some small studies in generalised anxiety disorder. But the drug companies don't seem interested, and it's very hard to get funding to do independent trials, but that's obviously what should be done.
OK, thanks for your time this morning. We really appreciate it, Roger. That is Professor Roger Mulder from Otago University.
Thank you.